Whoever said you can't have too many boats? Rude motor. This is a catamaran. And then coming out the driveway here, got those two boats in the garage. And just added to the fleet is this 14-foot High Laker speedboat that is going to visit a lot of the major lakes in Washington this summer.
Some back home, buddies in the field, mud on the wheels, yeah, ain't that some thick smoke, Silverado, tearing up a two-lane road, ain't that some C-O-U-N-T-R-Y.
Okay, well, can you believe it? It's here. We just got delivery of the boat, and we're working on getting it blocked in the driveway. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're trying to find something bigger to go under the front jack just to get the bow up more so it'll drain. Got big blocks. These are actually travel trailer tires. In the boat, there's a bunch of junk over here. That was a crab pot puller attachment, but it actually supports that side deck because these side decks originally don't have much support, as I'll show you here. They are just some wood backing in there, and this one isn't super strong. So you can see that right there, they made a cutout here to do another one, and I want to finish that project to make this side deck more stronger. And then the most major thing I would say is this transom. Good running 30 horsepower Yamaha oil injected. Thing's got a lot of power for its size. Electric start, but what you'll notice in here is this. Now they've made a series of mistakes here in letting this transom get to where it is now. First of all, you'll notice there's a bunch of water in here that's not draining. The main transom drain is this guy right here, and there's a through-haul metal piece, as you can see here, that keeps the transom in good quality. But hey, what are these? Well, for whatever reason, they decided that one drain wasn't enough, so they drilled two more holes and didn't put the metal insert in, and they partially filled them back up with silicon or silicone. That's this gray stuff. Now there's open wood that's rotting in the transom. So a temporary fix, we got this tarp on. And it's pretty good, just covers the motor. Important thing though, is it covers the entire transom. Down in here you can see the whole transom's covered. That's gonna be the biggest project that I'm not super looking forward to. There's a couple minor things around the transom that stuff like these corners are in pretty bad shape. This one specifically is not very good, but overall not too bad, and I really like the boat. As far as the survey, the first order of business that I'm gonna fix is kind of how I went in order. First I'm gonna fix the side deck, then we're gonna fix the transom. Why we're not doing the transom the most important first is because I don't have a huge amount of fiberglass experience. I know a fair amount about fiberglassing, but I haven't had much practice. So I'm going to first practice on a couple of pieces of wood, joining them. Then I'm going to practice doing reinforcing under this side deck. Then we're going to work on the transom. And then there's a couple other mainstream things that you'll notice. One is this awful looking floor. Now you might be wondering why this floor doesn't look so bad. Well, that's because this is the actual inner floor. This boat is like a sandwich. It's got the hull down here, which is this part down here. It's got the hull, and then up here is this thin floor. In between is air and a kind of a honeycomb structure. So the inner floor in here, which you can see right there, the guy who owned this actually broke a hole right there and back there in the inner floor. And so as a temporary fix, he just put this couple pieces of plywood that are really old in. Now, they've been in here a while because you can notice that is a mount for one of his downriggers, which you can see up here, a bunch of this equipment. Now, we're going to try to sell that at a swap meet. But there's a couple other things that need some help on this boat that are semi-major. One of which is this seat. It is just bare, bad plywood on the bottom. And it's pretty flexible. It's fiberglass on top, thin plywood on the bottom. It's been pretty abused. And there's stress cracks all along the side here. So that is definitely going to need some bolstering. This boat is pretty cool because it easily carries pretty much 14 to 16 gallons of fuel, which gives it a huge range. This boat, with 16 gallons of fuel, this boat will go over 100 nautical miles without refueling, which means that I could go to a lighthouse 50 miles away and back with no trouble. So that's going to be a lot of fun. There's two other points to this boat I want to mention, and that's up here. First off, on the left here, you'll notice this is an oarlock. Now, this boat didn't originally have this windshield. It had one that started about here, but this windshield starts back here. And it looks better, but that means this oarlock is non-functional. The other oarlock is right there. What I want to do is move that one up to here, and this one back to here. And then you can row from the sitting position. One person can row instead of two, and they'll just work better. Now, two other things, one of which is this upper deck. Now, this bow deck is just thin fiberglass. It's got some reinforcement, but it is not very strong. This is also our forward storage locker. But this upper fiberglass deck is going to need some support, some vertical support. The other thing, we need to get this old depth sounder working. And then what I've thought about, there's the fuse panel right there. All the controls are working. What needs to happen is some rewiring and electrical stuff. Redo the fuse panel and get a new waterproof one. And then along here, eventually, I don't want to cut too many holes in the boat, so I might do it right here, or I might do it up there in front of the steering wheel, is put a basic radio in. A radio that would do both VHF for boating and listening to music on AM/FM radio. So those are the main things that need to be done on the boat. In future videos, I will be going through exactly how we're going to do them, and taking you guys along for entertainment, and hopefully you can learn something from them. So yeah, overall, really cool boat, and it's good to have it home. Also, this thing I don't recommend doing to get the bow up, we put one of these Harbor Freight. Supposedly this holds like 350 pounds. This tongue is probably somewhere around 50, but you can notice a little bit of bend to it. And on the hill, it's not great. So at the moment, I can't actually get up inside the boat. This boat has some really cool lines though, especially on the hull. And it's gonna be a really fun project. This view will be awesome once we're underway. So with that out of the way, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye.